Aboard the battleship Missouri, on September 2, 1945, Japan surrenders unconditionally to the United States.
The years away at war changed many men. They had lived in the foulest conditions and seen too much death. Because of his shared experience with his black servicemen, Jaime Samuelson came to realize the stupidity of prejudice.
I must help stamp out this crazy idea that the white man has about his superiority over the colored man. The Negro is our equal physically. He is superior to us spiritually. He has the same intelligence as a white man. What he lacks is opportunity. And they are smart enough to know that we are wrong. But being in the minority, they can do nothing about it.
Most of the guys were glad to be back in the USA, not necessarily because of the welcome they were going to get, but just because they had families here. But some of the guys going by the Statue of Liberty talked about that dirty old bitch and things like that. Here we are back in the United States. And it wasn't too long after we got off the ship, before we recognized, just as you got off the ship, they had colored troops going in this direction and white troops going in this direction.
When I got home, I stopped at Grand Central Station, the biggest train station in Detroit, Class A uniform, with my fruit salad and a couple of stars we were awarded. I couldn't get a cab no place. No white cab would stop and pick me up.
A white sergeant from the other side, he came over and he saw my ribbons and he had been in the Pacific. And, you know, we started exchanging stories. And finally he says, "Sergeant, maybe you don't know, but the black people have to get that ticket around the other side."
So when the guy handed me my discharge papers, he didn't have half of my medals and nothing to the effect that I was wounded at all. And I went over and said, "This is not right. You don't have all my information down." He said, "This is correct. I'm doing this. And besides, a nigger, get back over there. You're not out of the service. If you say anything else, I'll call the MP and we'll put you in the stockade." Said, "You aren't out of the service yet.
Here you're fighting for your country, for the love of your country, and yet you don't really belong to it, or you don't feel like you belong to it." Well, they came back, some of them came back angry about that. Hell, I went over there and some of them were in battle and got injured, and here I gave all this time and I come back and I got to take all this crap. I'm not going to take it anymore. I think a lot of them felt that way. But it took time for the movement to really get started. It took about 20 years from, say, 45, 46, for it to really catch fire.
One thing was getting an education. Just so happened they had the Bill of Rights we could use and would pay for a lot of our education. And I used it to get my master's in metallurgical engineering from Ohio State while still working. It was something beyond the war that we wanted to do. We were still young, had that youthful enthusiasm, and we just wanted to do something.
They went to other countries and they were treated better in those countries than they were treated here in our own country.
After the end of the war, some of the Australian soldiers would correspond with the black American soldiers they'd met. Frederick and Frank would exchange Christmas cards.
He gave me his address, I give him mine. He said, "We'll keep in contact with each other after the war is over." And this is what happened. The first one I got was at Christmas time. I sent him one right back, you know. At Christmas time, we would send each other a letter.
I've often said I'd like to go back to Australia and see what it's like over there now. I never heard a black serviceman say he had a bad time in Australia. Nothing but good times. "Don't cry, my little baby, my baby, don't you cry. Now dry your eyes, let's be sweethearts again. You know I didn't mean to ever treat you so mean. So come on, sweetheart, let's try it over again.
Eastern State viewers are invited to join director Nicole McQuaig and some of the participants from Black Soldier Blues in a live web chat. To participate, go to www.sbs.com.au/storyline Australia.